Are you looking for a hill test system that's quick to set up and modular to fit your use case? I gotcha. Experience hill solutions differently. Stay tuned. My name is Julian and I am working at Vector as a developer for hill test systems. In this video, I will take you step by step through the VTE system, explaining each component and showing you how to get started. So, what is the VTE system? The modular VTE system is Vector's solution for open and closed loop testing. It is highly scalable and offers many plug-in modules for demanding real-time requirements, as well as comprehensive, precise, and fast I/O capabilities. And all modules are operated by Canoo. The VTE system can be used in a wide range of industries, from automotive to medical technology to aerospace. To address the specific project requirements, the systems are available in different form factors. The compact desktop case comes in two different sizes. The small one offers space for up to 6 boards, and the large one for up to 12 boards, which can be easily exchanged to adapt the test system to various projects. With a simple Cat7 cable, you can connect them together to create a true powerhouse of a VTE system. In addition to the desktop version, the VTE system is available as a 19-inch rack version for installation in a customized cabinet. Let's dive into a quick demo. It's about a man-in-the-middle approach to communication. This means we will switch between two participants in an Ethernet network. We use a Raspberry Pi to simulate the Ethernet data over an ECU. This serves as our DUT. For the VTE system, I need a plug-in board VT6306. Here you see the 1 gigabit version, which is already in the rack. There's also a 100 megabit version available. Both could be used with the Raspberry Pi. The VT6060 module is also required. It's a built-in computer to process the communication data. We connect it with a PCI Express cable to the VT6306, which in turn is connected to the Raspberry Pi via Ethernet. The VT6306 is connected to the laptop. In this scenario, it serves as the man-in-the-middle hardware. Finally, the VT6060 must be connected to the rack as well as the laptop. The hardware is ready. Now it's time for the software. In the Vector Hardware Manager, we load a prepared configuration and deploy it to the VT6306 to make it act as a switch. This whole step could even be automated. Let's start the trace in Canoo to see the data of the Ethernet communication. After we connect and log into the Raspberry Pi, all its Ethernet data is displayed in the trace. We see the data exchange between the DUT and the console window, and Canoo is now the man in the middle. Canoo makes any form of Ethernet communication easy, whether you analyze the communication of a cheap setup or a complex vehicle. As you have just seen, a test system can be set up with the VTE system in just a few steps. Get in touch if you would like to get the man-in-the-middle config we used in our example. We offer different VTE modules to meet all common use cases in the development process. The contact information is in the description. Regardless if the development state of your hardware, convenient control and tests are possible. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more about the VTE system, please subscribe to the Vector channel. Activate the bell so you don't miss any videos. And as always, if you have any feedback or questions, please feel free to contact us. Thanks for watching and see you next time.